Yo, what's up, my people? It's your boy Marcus Dave once again. So this is one of, like the caption says, man, I found myself accidentally in a gothic party. Shit, damn. This one among the scariest moments in my life. Damn, that was one hell of a scary moment. I still have it in my mind till today, but which, even though it happened like 5 or 6 years back, you know, that time I was still a freshling in here in Germany, you know. So I was kind of 3 years old already, but now in a new city. So this is how it all went down. So I like I said, I was already 3 years in Germany, or it was my third year in Germany. So previously I lived here in Hannover, but now I had just relocated to Osnabrück. I was there for 3 months or so. So in this period of time, 3 months, while I was starting my campus life over there, I kind of got to have some new friends. Kind of met some few Kenyan people over there, people from Jamaica, people from Trinidad, from all over, you know. So I was starting my new life over there in Osnabrück. So now it was on a Thursday evening or afternoon. So there was this one Jamaican guy who used to organize parties and everything there over there. I had met him, like, now he was a good friend of mine already. So this guy rings me up on a Thursday, like, Yo, what up, youth man? What's up, youth man? David, man, how you doing, bro? For real, I've never met any Jamaican or Trinidad person who speaks German direct to you. The moment they know you understand English, they'll be on their patois or this kind of English they always speak, you know. So this guy, like I said, rang me up. Yo, David, what you do? How you doing, youth man? How you doing? How you feeling, bro? And I'm like, yo, bro, me fine, me just chilling, you know. Just relaxing, enjoying life, giving thanks to life for life, you know. So he tell me up like, yo, you know, they were made through bashment parties, you know. Yeah, I got party coming up tomorrow, bro. I'm like, ah, you got party tomorrow? Yeah, I got tomorrow. I'll be throwing a hip hop dancehall party over here. So I'm like, yeah, cool. Which location? I'm like, yeah, it's a place called Hyde Park. It's a bit outside of the city, but. It will be a big party, you know. All us throw big parties, you know, huge bomber club party, you know. So I'm like, yeah, cool, no problem. Send me the address and I'ma pull up tomorrow, no problem. And he was like, yeah, cool, bro. Come, we have to mash up this party tomorrow. So I'm like, yeah, no problem, bro. Don't forget to send me the address. So he was like, yeah, cool, okay. See you later, see you then. So he kind of sent me the address, you know. So I kind of checked the address quickly. I saw, okay, yeah, he was right. It's outside of the city a bit. So I didn't bother checking much information about the location. So I thought it's just another club where I go to get to have a gig. So didn't bother much. Now come Friday, when the party is supposed to be, went on my day, went to campus. In the evening, I went to my jobo. So after I checked out of my work, it was around 9 p.m. in the evening. So I'm now driving back home to go clean up, refresh a bit, have something to eat and everything, and then now hit the party. So I was in that party mood. It's Friday, and so I'm this kind of mood, you know. So just ate, cleaned up. Now it was around 11 p.m. So normally clubs in Germany open at 11 p.m. That's when the clubs always open doors. Before that, people always go to pubs, or sometimes the teenagers over here go buy drinks from the supermarket and everything. They go sit somewhere in the city and drink their drinks all over with loud boombox and everything. So that was a normal routine type of thing. But this is winter time now. Winter time, there's not much of these activities outside. So winter time, most people always go like chill out in the house with friends, and then they go out for parties. So me, I've just come out of work. It's already heading to 11 p.m. So I thought, like, yeah, I can't chill in the house for another 1 hour before I go to, because mind you, I said parties doors open at 11 p.m. But nobody comes at 11 p.m. to the club. So people always start checking in at midnight or 1 a.m. in the morning. So they have to drink something back at home, and then, or outside, or whatever it is. Winter time, definitely not outside. Some funny locations. They always meet up in somebody's crib, drink a bit, and then go for party. So this time I thought, okay, it's already 11. I don't need to look for people to go hang out at their place before we go to the club. So I thought, like, let me just go direct to the club. It's 11 p.m. I know it's a bit early. Nobody's arriving at this time. People will arrive a bit later. So that's my mindset. I thought, okay, cool. This is the plan. Checked out how I'm going to get there. I saw like, yeah, kind of public transportation to that place. It was kind of creepy. That town was a bit small. So late in the evening, there were no buses. There was that they never had tram in that city. So there were no buses and everything. So I thought like, nah, I'm not going to pay for taxi for this shit. So best option is, I don't feel, yeah, I'm in the mood to party, but I don't want to stay till late now. I thought like, let me just drive myself up there with my car. I'm going to drink only 2-3 beers and then later on drink water and then I'll be fine to drive back. So I had the plan set in my mind. So cool, okay, get early in the club. Even if it's not that much hyped up, you can just have 3-4 beers and then later on you can chill out, party, the club will be filled, the party will be going on. So that I had that strategy in my mind, so I'm heading to the club. So drove over there, kind of used my navigation, got to the location. I'm like seeing a huge parking lot. I'm like, oh shit, I'm used to parties in the town where, you know, no parking lot, you have to go look. I even don't bother going with the car when I'm going to party in the town. So but this place, big parking lot, so I'm like, oh damn, this place looks like a bit isolated, you know, it's somewhere outside, you know. So parked my car next to the not so far from the entrance of the club, got in, left my jacket in the car. Like I said, it's winter time, so it was around January, February there. I can't remember exactly which month, but it was really cold outside. So kind of left my jacket inside the car so I don't have to give it the jacket area. So since I have my car here, I can just lock it in. A few seconds, I'm already inside the club. The club is already, I know it's warm. So put my jacket, went in, opened the first door. Now, two security guys were standing there actually. Two big monster people there standing there. So I'm like, yo, what's get up, man? They were just simple hello, saluting them. They're, yeah, other person. So yeah, I can. So now I said hello to them, but now I'm walking past them. But I felt like they wanted to say something. But at that moment, I could already hear the music. I'm like, what the fuck kind of music is this? So I'm just past the security. Next is the cashier there. I'm like, yeah. So I knew this is the address this guy sent me. So I thought, no, I cannot. It was just some, I could not make the decision real quick because, you know, I'm just past the security. This is the cashier over here. I'm seeing there was a poster already of the dance hall hip hop party also around there. So I saw, okay, the poster is here, but I'm like, music is a bit different. What the fuck is wrong? So I kind of asked the on the flyer there was a price of the entry of the place. Yeah, I think it was 10 euros. So I kind of had my 10 euros in my hand. I gave it up and she was like, for the next party? And I'm like, yeah, for the next party, because I kind of noticed it's basically not the party I'm here for. So it must be the next party. So I said, yeah, for the next party. So yeah, for the next party. So basically she's speaking German to me. So I'm like, yeah, okay. I got my stamp. So I'm like, let me try simulate this. So I'm past now. I'm done with the cashier, past the security guys. Now there's another door in front of me. The door is kind of now the last hurdle to get to the main club area. So the music is loud, you know, they're still loud. So I'm like, damn, am I really in the right place? So I thought like, okay, let me go in, let me see what's happening, you know. I opened the door, pushed the door, and I got inside. The moment I opened the door, the music was now loud. The moment I opened the door, I could see black dressed people jumping up and down to the bish, bish, bah, bah, bish, bish, bah, bah, bish. I'm like, shit, where the fuck am I here? You know, that moment you open the door and you realize, shit, you've got yourself in trouble or what? You know, that was what was running in my mind. At that moment, I'm like, shit. And now they kind of, there was a few of them who were over here. They kind of noticed the doors opened and they were now looking at me. So I'm like, And I was like, no, you have to go back, bro. You have to go back. So by the time I was like wanting to go back, I just kind of noticed on them on the right side of the place. I noticed at the counter there were two, you know, when somebody's dressed differently, you definitely notice in that kind of situation. The laser lights and the lighting was like, psh, psh, you know, that this guy. But I noticed some kind of brighter clothes on the other side. So I'm like, then I saw there were two chicks and one dude. They were whites. They were already there. I knew them, and they were definitely, we've been them in some other parties together. So I kind of, when I was wanting to go back, they kind of saw me, and I saw them, and they were like, yo, come over. I'm like, ah, yo, shit, I saw you guys are here. So I kind of thought, like, should I go in or should I go back? I decided, like, I gathered my courage, and I was like, okay, let me go there. Let me go to those people over there. So there, I'm a bit safer, you know. So that's now confirmed to me I'm not in the wrong place, but I'm in the wrong party. People are jumping and crazy. So I have to make my way now to there, where my friends are, you know. So in order to get there, I have to tap some few gothic people to give me way, you know, because some of them are looking on the other side. They are party. They are in small circles with their friends, and some others are talking and drinking their beer. So I'm like, surely, and some of them are like turning back, seeing a black guy inside their party, you know. And it was kind of, you know, you expect I didn't know what to expect when they're turning back and trying to give me way. So they were like, I'm like, shit, like, I kind of made my way till where my friends were, you know. I got there, I'm like, shit, Leute, was left here, man? And they were like, yeah. Is in Etwas Früh, yeah? You know, Etwas Früh means we are a bit early. So I'm like, wieso, Etwas Früh? I thought the party starts at 11 p.m. And nine. So the music is still up, bish, bam, bam. So I'm trying to converse with them. Like, no, the hip hop dance party is starting at midnight. So I'm like, checked on my watch, 20 minutes early. So I'm kind of, shit, where the fuck am I here inside, you know? There are three white people, two Chileans, one dude. They're white, so for me, I'm not yet comfortable since I know I'm the only black guy there. So these are white people, so they are somehow related, but I'm the outcast at this moment. And that time, I had a really bad mindset about it. You know, I didn't know what to expect from these people because I've never encountered Gothic people one to one. I just saw one or two people around the city walking by or something like that. But I've never been in a same room with more than 100 of them, you know. Chileans, you could notice they have their hot pants, black, with some tight meshed top, you know, lipstick, everything black, hair completely black dyed and everything, funny piercings. And they were there, but I'm like, shit, fuck. I need some hard stuff to be here, you know. I thought, like, you should now get a glass of whiskey or something just to calm me down. But I was like, no, you're driving, so you should order for my beer. I sat there with my three other friends. Well, like, I now sat back and started watching how they're behaving, you know, with that kind of instinct moment, trying to be alert. If anything happens, you can. You know, that instinct, I could not, it's a place you could not be comfortable at any second, you know, but the music was really crap, man. I'm trying to understand how these people think, how these people work, you know. And I was sitting there, I had already ordered my beer. My beer was yet to be brought. Then there was one among the Gothic people there. I think there was two chicks now. I'm sitting at the counter, there's a space here, so they came, they wanted to order a drink and something, and they were like, bist du was trinken? I'm like, nee, danke, schon hab schon was bestellt, yeah? I'm like, you guys are offering me a beer or what? I can't even drink that kind of beer, but I'll never get that offer. But I was, yeah, danke schon, aber ich hab was schon bestellt. So, and all smiles, and they left, and I was like, shit. 20 minutes went by, and that kind of holy crap of a shit of music. I'm like, shit. Holy. Damn, I've never been scared that way in my life, man. This is one of the scariest moments I've ever had in my life. So, time went by, 20 minutes. The music was, the party was over, they left. Later on, the Jamaican guy shows up. Yo, bro, what's up, Daddy? What? Yo, bum. I'm like, looking at him, I'm like, you bumbucklehead, why you don't tell me this? There's another pot in between, man. You just tell me the party starting. And I'm like, yeah, yeah, ah, my bad. I thought you're gonna check it up, you know. I thought you're gonna check it up and see it started midnight and before this. It's an event place. People make parties and different kind of parties, you know. I'm like, yo, bro, you should just warn me, like, before it's a gothic party. So, I know, my bad, bro. Next time we're gonna tell you everything, you know. Yeah, man. So we ended up having the dance for Liverpool party. Some other friends of mine came and everything. We had a mad party that evening. I ended up leaving the place at 6 a.m. in the morning, drove back home. And I was like, shit. The next day I was just waking up. I was like, shit, that was close. That was close, man. You know, I've never the place was dark in that club. It's only the laser lights and everything. And you're seeing these kind of people. This kind of music, you don't know what to expect, you know. That day, I've never been scared of my life than that day. So that's the experience I had with the gothic people in a club, man. That's how it went down. Yeah, man. So for more stories and more other experience that I've had here in Germany, check out my other videos, which I'm gonna be posting some other time to share my stories with you guys. Yeah. Otherwise, have a lovely day. Peace out.